Azure Security Center could be a complicated service. We're going to take it apart, put it back together, and tell you everything you need to know about what it is, why you should use it, and of course, as always, how we can make it work for you. All that and more coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, edutainer here at ITProTV, back with another fun and exciting episode in our ongoing conversation around what is Azure. We're going to take a look at the Azure Security Center in this conversation, and as always, we'll answer our three questions. What is the Azure Security Center? Why is it important for you? What value does it hold for you and your organization? And equally importantly, how do we actually put this to work for you, get it up and running, and make sure you understand how to use it? Let's begin by talking about the concept of what the Azure Security Center is, what it represents for us in terms of functionality. When we think about the Azure Security Center, we're representing that with our cloud right here, with all the different elements inside of it. What we represent and think about really is the idea of being able to monitor first and foremost, looking at and understanding what's going on across our entire landscape, both inside of Azure, looking at all the Azure services, the capabilities, and of course, all the things that go on there, and thinking about integrating really leading edge, cutting edge technology and functionality. We bring in potentially the use of Windows Defender, the advanced threat protection engine that Microsoft has in the Microsoft Azure platform, as well as our ability to link out to some other Azure services, one of which we've already taken a look at and talked about in our What is Azure conversations, the Azure Sentinel solution. Our ability to use a cloud-based SIEM solution to be able to bring together all of the data, analysis of it, and then telling us where threats may lie is directly integrated and potentially available to us here as part of Security Center's functionality. So we see kind of all of that represented. And then we want to think about the fact that this is first and foremost an Azure-centric solution. We monitor inside of Azure all the things going on, but not just there. We can monitor out into potentially AWS and Google and other clouds. We can monitor on-premises capabilities in terms of our infrastructure that is in hybrid and deployed in those kind of configurations. And so we can look at this as an Azure-only solution or an Azure plus cloud and plus on-premises solution, bringing together our visibility of workloads, of examination of events and capabilities that may exist in one area but not potentially in others, bringing that all together so that we can look at it, we can analyze it, we can understand it, and we can report on it. So as we think about what Azure Security Center represents, it represents an all-up holistic view of our platform-specific and widely distributed capabilities across Azure and any and all other IaaS infrastructure, PaaS platform, and SaaS software as a solution areas. We can then have visibility into all of them. So we like the fact that we have what we refer to as a single pane of glass, a single source of truth that allows us to understand what's happening and really bring in those flows from these different areas and centrally be able to analyze them. When we think about broadening our conversation out into the why, why would a tool like this, a capability set such as Azure Security Center provides, why would it be important to us? Well, the exact reasons that I already mentioned. Visibility into multi-cloud areas where we are running most likely additional workloads. We want to know what's going on in AWS, for instance, and we certainly can use AWS's own built-in security and monitoring and SIEM capabilities. Same with the Google Cloud. They each individually provide similar services and capabilities. But the problem is they're platform specific and they may or may not extend out through this bi-directional flow that we can represent here. They may or may not extend out and give us visibility into the Azure cloud. By Azure Security Center being able to connect out and bring in this information and then show it to us, reporting on it and telling us, hey, there's something going on, right? Let's pay attention here. Let's be concerned about this. Put a little exclamation point there for an alert and make sure that we know that there's a problem in AWS that we have to check on, or maybe in one of our on-prem solutions, right? Right over here, or even over here, where maybe this area inside of our data center is experiencing an issue and we want to be told about that and be alerted to what's going on. Any and all of these things are possible with Azure Security Center. So the ability to monitor far-flung infrastructure, aggregating and centralizing all that information, is really the strength of this platform and really one of the key value propositions that help us to understand why this would be such a good investment for us. And speaking of investments, this is built in. This is free. This service exists as part of the core Azure subscription that you already have access to. What we call the standard tier for Azure Security Center is already available to you. No additional cost. Simply just opting in and allowing it to be used and to understand how to use it is all it takes. So we like the fact that the basics are already built in. We get recommendations on best practices, assessment of environments, and opportunity to understand how to mitigate risk and minimize threat, all out of the box. We have what's known as an additional tier where we can, for 30 days free of charge, bring in the Windows ATP, the Windows Advanced Threat Protection with Defender. Then we start to pay as we go, monitoring workloads and services on a monthly basis beyond that. So there is some additional upcharging here, but we can monitor virtual machines that are running, services that are being provided, and capabilities that extend into all these different areas for essentially a pay-as-you-go solution. So we like the scalability as well as the flexibility. So we always do, we're going to move out of talking about our what and our why and move into our how, showing you how you actually can spin up, deploy, and ultimately use the solution we're focusing on, in this case, the Azure Security Center. All right, everybody. So we're going to take a look at how we actually can get Security Center up and running. We're in the Azure portal. What we're going to do is zoom in quickly, show you the several ways to search for the Security Center, to access and to ultimately start using its functionality. Really just a matter of what you're most comfortable with. We can begin by looking at the fact that in the portal, once we log in the home area, we usually see a bunch of shortcut area tiles, right? These individual icons we can click on right there. And the Security Center is usually one of those Azure services that displays there. We can grab it right from there. It's the second icon over, moving left to right. It's got the little Security Center shield. We can go to all services and search. We can even go to our shortcut menu down below. And more often than not, it will be in the list towards the bottom. You could see it right down there as I hover over it. And we can click right on the link. We can see useful documentation, including the pricing information about the standard versus the upscale tier that I mentioned, and the 33 days, and then the pay-as-you-go information, if you want to check all that out. Let's assume we're going to click on one of those links to launch the Security Center. And when we do see that we have our overview area, which really just shows us the ability to see what subscription or subscriptions, if we have more than one, will be monitored. We can link and add and filter additional subscriptions right there. We will begin to see recommendations as the tool is working. So as we add infrastructure and things are happening, we'll see this will change and update over time. We do see our recommendations as well as potentially alerts. And we can see our secure score dashboard card there along with clickable links around the score. And we can see insights that are offered around recommendations that Microsoft is making based on looking at our infrastructure, all the things we're doing in Azure, and recommending that perhaps we approach doing some things a certain way. Perhaps changing a configuration, maybe adding a service or modifying some sort of setting, because across the platform globally, as Microsoft examines, manages millions of data points every day, looking at threat analysis deeply, but also looking at security, configuration, and optimization of resources. They begin to develop this best practice guidance, and they extend it and share it with all of us through the Security Center. It's one of the key value adds that we get here. Now, depending on where you wind up clicking, you may wind up on the Getting Started area. This is just a link right below Overview. And this is going to allow us to be able to do two really important things. Upgrade our subscription if we're using the free tier, where we have just basic coverage and we're not implementing the advanced features using Windows Defender, the advanced threat protection capabilities I mentioned, and the per workload monitoring that we can pay for and use. We may want to take advantage of that. We can do that with upgrade. And we do see information here about our 30-day free trial that I've mentioned. We get the ability to then look at upgrading, and we can read up a little bit more about some of the additional capabilities like just-in-time administration, what's called JIT, J-I-T, adaptive application controls, and a whole bunch of really cool additional technology and features that Microsoft does offer us. Remember, this is a pay-as-you-go solution. We can see the subscriptions that are available to us to add the Windows Defender and ATP capabilities to. We check those off and select them. And then we're able to see what the pricing, the menu is on the workload protection capabilities we pay for on a per instance, per month basis as we go. Things like Kubernetes, so we can look at, for instance, our container solutions and our hosted workloads. We can look at our key vaults and protect those. We can look at storage accounts, SQL Server and additional database instances, web application server instances, and of course, virtual machines. And you could see what those pricing points are. They do change over time, so obviously just pay attention to that. But we can see all of that here. And then, of course, we can simply upgrade once we make appropriate selections. Keep in mind, Microsoft does modify these offerings over time. There may be a 30-day free option when you go to look at this. There may be something different. So don't be put off by that or worry about that, but do pay attention to the kinds of workloads you want to protect and then enable them accordingly. The good news is you could turn on and off these features on a rolling basis. So if you have new databases you're bringing online and want to protect them, enable that for that period of time, but then simply go in and deselect it when you're done. You don't pay for those things unless you actually consume them. So we like that capability as well. And then if we look over here, just in terms of our navigation area, we can easily see that we can move into the recommendation area. Looking at those recommendations, many of them are clickable and have actions associated with them that we can then be taken directly to that area and potentially engage in. See the same thing for alerts. We could see inventory information. We could delve into specific areas like cloud security, bringing in that Azure Defender integration if we upgrade, as well as looking at management. And we can look at not just pricing and settings like we're looking at on the overview page, but we can look at our workflow automation, we can look at policy, and look at all the different elements that exist here. Let's take a look at a high level quickly at what recommendations may look like. What do we see from this tool? We like the fact we can get this information provided in the interface, but notice we can download this and work with it offline as well, sharing it with others and broadly communicating this to get buy-in from additional stakeholders and then be able to leverage that mind share, right? Going back in here and making choices and taking actions as a result. And we can see we have an overall secure score. This gives us a percentage rating based on the overall number of things that are being assessed. We're roughly at 1/3 of that, meaning about 17 out of 55 points have been assessed as okay or not okay. You can look at that either way. And then we then have to go in and take some action. We can drill through there. We do have recommendations and we can see the status of them. And we can see that we're invited to learn more about various things. We also see overall resource health and indicators of that as well. Any and all of this is going to be very helpful if I drill through here. Let me just highlight and scroll down. We can see what recommendations may look like. We have guidance up underneath each one enabling multi-factor authentication, and it tells us that right now we're not doing that, but we can easily go in if we choose to. We can open this up. We can look at these sub recommendations broken out by area, one of which I apparently have taken advantage of, the other I have not. And I can drill through these, taking step-by-step guidance and really actionable information and outcomes that Microsoft recommends, holds our hand, and shows us exactly what to do. So when we look at implementing the Security Center, in terms of our how, the answer is really simple. It's already there. We just have to start using it effectively, maybe upgrading our capabilities, bringing on more functionality and paying for it as we go. If you want to see me go through this in more depth, really understand end-to-end how you can leverage the Security Center to the best benefit for your organization, I go through this in much more detail over in ITProTV, where I run several different courses that focus on this and a lot of other Azure security solutions. Invite you to come over and take a look, spend time with me there. Always glad to spend more time telling you about how things work. Until I come back with another exciting What is Azure conversation, I'm going to wish you happy Azuring, and I'll see you soon.